Hello guys. Good morning. It's 9 a.m. Sunday, the 19th of January. Welcome to Apex Brew House. Today I have been mostly brewing coffee, although I have American Pilsner entering boil stage behind the wall. So something is happening. This is kind of a product review, or let's say first experience from a cleaning device. Everybody who has been into home brewing knows that this hobby is mostly about washing and sanitizing, and secondly, if you are lucky, you can do beer as well, but it is mostly washing. I hate that part. Sometimes I kind of postpone it, and everybody knows what happens when you postpone the cleaning. It's super difficult. So now actually, lately, I have been brewing in two stages. I mash day one and unsparge, and when I have the kind of the pre-boil volume done, I stop and I empty the malt pipe, clean everything up and leave the boiling off the wort for the next morning. And that is actually what is happening now. I mashed yesterday and wort is coming currently to a boil. Just to kind of split it on two different days, so all the, you know, it's not overwhelming, the cleaning and whatnot. So this has been so far working very nicely for me, and I have everything like tip top, and yeah. So, but one thing which I'm having a bit of a backlog is that I have dirty bottles. I have already kind of outsourced my keg cleaning and fermenter cleaning by getting two of these. So this is the Mark keg washer. I have actually two of these, and to understand why I have two of those, please check my some of my previous videos and you can learn it from there. I'm not going to tell that story again. Not my proudest moment. The keg washer has been, it's good, first of all. It's good and it's relatively easy to clean. So it's not kind of this situation where the cleaning is just kind of moved to another device. So it's fairly simple to clean. It's basically just rinsing it off and it's good. So for the keg cleaning, actually I have made one enhancement. There's this rod which will actually shoot the cleaning solution up to the keg, and it has this nozzle. Is that the correct word? Nozzle. So that's, this is not kind of rocket science version. So I upgraded. Okay, it went there. To this sip bowl, clean in place device. So I think the idea is that you will have a jet of water hitting this bowl. The bowl will start to rotate and, you know, spray everywhere with a nice pressure. And it just goes to the same thread. Boom. Zzz. This is kind of the magic wand of homebrewer. Anywho, well, that's one thing. But I have even now decided to take it a little bit further. And I've... let's put this away. Just a sec. And I got myself one of these. 22-ounce bottle washing system. So this is not what you call a standalone product. So this is kind of add-on to the Mark cake washer. So you need to have the cake washer before you can use this. As you can see, I haven't even opened the box. I thought that we'd do it together and that might be fun. So let's see if I can position you guys a little bit better so you can see. What do we have here? Just checking how would this actually open up. And I think I just need to rip it open from the end. So let's do that then. Okay, there's some glue, heavy glue. Right, that's filled with stuff. Do I need to take this tape? No, I guess I didn't. Okay, so this is a filled with stuff. Very sturdy packaging there. So there we have something which I think will be the actual cleaning for nozzles, which will go into the bottle, I think should be. So that's one thing. Instructions pamphlet. Ah, okay. Set of seals. Lot of which I think are stainless steel screws with these wing nuts. Okay. So it seems that this is not ready from the box, so it will require, actually it seems, quite a lot of, I don't know what these are. These are the same, whatever these are. Kind of round things, so probably. Okay, there's one tape. Cut through that. Do not snap threads, it says. The manifold is in the correct position only once per turn. Do not over tighten, but back up to the last good one. What? But back up to the last good one, even if it seems too loose, to keep from breaking off the threads. Ah, okay. So I think what they are trying to say that when you position this and you probably turn it to tighten, so when it starts to get tight and it should still go forward, instead of still tightening it up, go a little bit back to the correct position, not to screw up the thread. That's my interpretation. All right, here we have something like that. Then that's empty. Okay. So what I'm seeing now is that we have, you know, two racks for the puddles. I think that was also the what it says. If you look at the picture, so we have clearly this kind of washing thingy that will attach to the cake washer, and then we have two separate racks for the puddles. And I believe that if we look at the manifold, it has 8 holes. So I think it can wash 8 puddles per time, and you need to move the rack in the device to get it all clean. So we have what, 15 puddles per rack. How that, well, you know what, let's get it built. I'm just wondering, should I film it anyway, what I'm doing here, and I'll see later whether it's usable material for this video. So let's see. Next thing which will happen, I will find some empty puddles and let's take it from there. Welcome back. So I have it there, filled with cleaning solution. I used the NC Brew. This stuff here, I think it's good, recommended. So let's install the tray and let's see what happens. I missed one. First issue, I cannot get the puddles aligned. So I needed to take the puddles out and put it then there. And the whole idea is that you can have all the puddles here. 8 of them will be washed per time. And then you just flip it over and the rest will be washed. So, big minus. But then again, it says that it's meant for 22-ounce puddles, which I think is like 0.5 liter here in Europe. So this is the issue then. Which is a sad thing, because this is the bottle that I'm using in my home brewery. I have like a jillion of these. So what will need to happen next is that I need to find good size bottle that will fit that, so that I don't have this problem. And then I will just basically change the bottles in my brewery. Not that difficult. So whenever I bottle and share or whatnot, I will just tell to people that, you know, you don't need to bring the bottles back. You can recycle them. So that needs to happen. Okay, what a bummer, but that's life. So let's plug it in and let's see what happens. If now all the nozzles are aligned and everything, yeah, so cool. funky voice. More noise is coming from my extension cord. Let's see if I will get wet now. I didn't. Cool. Let's take a flashlight somewhere. There we are. So yeah. Important factor, I don't want it to be kind of spraying water here and there. So the area will stay dry, that's important. Looks good. Okay, I'll let it rip and then somehow turn it around. And then I can also show you guys how I'm planning to do the next step. Because now they are kind of cleaning up, but will be dirty in a sense that there's the washing detergent. So I need to rinse them out. Okay, let's get back soon. The drip pan is something that I have separately purchased. It's not kind of included in this setup. So, not perfect, at least for the small bottles. I might just use it so that I put the rack here and then just insert manually or by hand the bottles, wash them, rinse them and put a second set. It doesn't fully utilize the setup like that, so let's see. And to clean this up, I'm just going to rinse it at this point and I will open it after a few uses to see whether they are, I don't know. Could be that I will actually open it to make sure that nothing will start growing inside of that manifold. All right. That's it. Hope you enjoyed. Hopefully this will ease my bottle washing regime. I'm sure it will. But other than having these handicaps which I mentioned, the build is solid. It's kind of good quality plastic, so I'm happy with that. I will revisit this later on down the road when I have used it a couple of times to give my final verdict. And I will get some bigger bottles as well to see whether that then works better. Cool. See you. Thanks for watching. Subscribe if you want to see me more and get alarm whenever I post. Guess that's it. Happy brewing. See you.